Hey, in this tutorial I'll show you EBUSUITE's ISF plugin. Use the ISF plugin to manipulate or generate visuals. In this case, I'm using an EVDWin plugin with an ISF plugin to distort the visual input of that camera. The ISF plugin uses ISF shader files that determine the effect and the behavior of the plugin. You can download these shaders from the Interactive Shader Format website. There are more than 1500 shaders available on this website, so there's much you can do with this ISF plugin. There are three types of ISF shader files. Filters that you can use to distort or manipulate visuals, generators that you can use to generate visuals, and transition shaders that you can use to mix between visuals. EBUSUITE doesn't support all ISF shader files, but most of them, and there are many of them. So you can just look for a cool shader file on the ISF website. Just click on them and play with them on the side. So you can see their effect and see if you like it or not. And in that way, just look for a cool shader. This one, or this is a cool one. Or this one. So when you found a shader that you like, you can very easily download it by just clicking the download button that's here, and now it's downloaded and you can add it to EBUSUITE. To do so, go to the EBUSUITE folder that you find in the user library of Ableton. In that folder, you'll find all the EBUSUITE plugins and a folder called EFX. In that folder, you find the ISF plugin and a folder called ISF, and that's where you collect all your ISF shader files. As you can see, there are already two folders in there. They come with the installation, but you can organize your shaders any way you like. So I'm going to add a new folder. I call it My Shaders, and I just drag it in there. Now I can go to Ableton and open an ISF plugin. And I'm now use the browser of the plugin to find my shader. As you can see, the browser is automatically pointed to the ISF folder. So here you see the same three folders that are in there: EBUSTUDIO, Standard, and the newly created My Shaders folder. So if I select that, then in that folder I find the shader I just downloaded. So I select it. As you can see, the plugin automatically creates an interface, and that interface has the same controls as you were using on the website. Only now you can use it in Ableton Live. So I stop this one, I start this one, and I can now play with it in Live. And I can map it to a controller or map it to, for example, an envelope follower. And now I can control it live. Okay, so let's add another layer. Super easy, just go to Interactive Shader Format website, find a cool shader. Now I like this one, download it, go to the EBUSUITE folder, to the ISF folder, and I drag the shader in there. And as you can see, this shader consists of two files, so I drag them both in the folder. And I go back to Ableton, the ISF plugin, I refresh it. Then I go directory higher, go to the My Shaders folder, and here it is. I click on it. The plugin generates an interface. And now, if I press play, here it is. And I can play with it in Ableton Live and map it and jam with it. Thank you. The ISF plugin works behind an eSampler, eSimpler, or Eclipse plugin, or eSiphon In or eVideo In plugin. Important. The resolution and dimensions of the ISF shader is determined by the resolution and dimension of the video or image that is loaded into the eSimpler, eSampler, or Eclipse track, or by the resolution and dimensions of the camera or siphon stream. An ISF shader can be very demanding on your computer, causing it to slow down, so you should experiment and find out which resolutions it can handle. You can try Full HD, but you should also try smaller sizes like 1280 by 720 or 960 by 540. You can easily try different sizes by loading different visuals and images on your tracks. Experiment and find out the right settings for your system. So the resolution of the shader is determined by the video that's playing on the track, so you can very easily change that resolution. To do so, I'll add some different images with different sizes to this track. See, this is an image like this, and I got a bunch of them. And if I play them, so if I play this image, now the resolution is 920 by 1080 because that is the resolution of the image. And if I play this one, it's 1280 by 720, 960 by 540. Now it's square, 720 by 720, 640 by 360, 480 by 270. And as you can see, there's a great effect on the resolution and the quality of the shader, and therefore the performance of your computer. Use this button, the Show Code and Credits button, to see who made the shader and to see how it works. On the Interactive Shader Format website, you can also go to the EboSuite channel that we have there. So if you look for EboSuite, you'll find our channel and the shaders that we have uploaded. You can download them, use them. There are many shaders on the website. Just look around, download them. There's a lot of you can do with the ISF plugin. So, have fun.